The purpose of this video is to provide information regarding the 2017 HUD HMIS data standards changes. These changes go into effect on October 1st, 2017. HMIS data standards provide communities with baseline data collection requirements developed by the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development, referred to as HUD, the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, referred to as HHS, and the U.S. Department of Veteran Affairs, referred to as the VA. These three entities are collectively referred to as the federal partners. Universal data elements are elements required to be collected by all projects entering data in the Nevada CMIS/HMIS. This includes projects that are funded by one or more of the federal partners, as well as those that are not funded by any of the federal partners. The universal data elements include name, date of birth, social security number, race, ethnicity, gender, veteran status, disabling condition, living situation, project start date, previously referred to as project entry date, project exit date, destination, client location, relationship to head of household, and housing move-in date. We will discuss this universal data element later. To meet the statutory and regulatory requirements of federally funded programs using HMIS, additional elements are required for different funding sources. The program-specific data elements are elements that are designed and managed by at least one of the HMIS federal partner programs. Program-specific data elements include income and sources, non-cash benefits, health insurance, physical disability, developmental disability, chronic health condition, HIV/AIDS, mental health problem, substance abuse, domestic violence, contact, date of engagement, bed night date, and housing assessment disposition. Federal partner program data elements are data elements that are specific to each federal partner. For example, T-cell, CD4, and viral load are collected for clients in HOPL-funded projects. Other federal partner program data elements include VAMC station number and SSVF services provided, which are required for clients in VA-funded projects. Sexual orientation, school status, and dental health status, which are required for clients in RHY-funded projects. And PATH status in connection with SOAR, which are required for clients in PATH-funded projects. Updates to fields, including their response options and names, will occur behind the scenes. Some updates, such as pick list option response changes, will go into effect prior to October 1st. All changes are required to go into effect no later than October 1st, 2017. If you have questions about the data standards after viewing this video, you may wish to review the 2017 Data Standards Dictionary. The dictionary can be found at www.hudexchange.info/resources/documents/hmis-data-dictionary.pdf. You may also direct any questions to the Nevada support team. In Southern Nevada, call 702-614-6690, extension 2. In Northern and Rural Nevada, call 775-562-4644, extension 2. You may also email the Nevada support team at nevada@bitfocus.com. Now we'll review changes to the standard enrollment screen. The field Housing Status at Entry, data element number 4.1, will be removed from the standard enrollment screen. Homelessness status will be determined by the responses to fields in the Living Situation section of the screen. The dependent fields Receiving Services and Documented will no longer be collected. This applies to all disabling condition types: physical disability, developmental disability, chronic health condition, HIV/AIDS, mental health problem, and substance abuse. In addition to be removed from the standard enrollment screen, these dependent fields will also be removed from the standard status screen as well as the standard exit screen. The field residential move-in date was previously collected for rapid rehousing projects. With the new data standards, the field would be renamed housing move-in date and will be applicable to all permanent housing project types, including permanent supportive housing, permanent housing, housing only, permanent housing, housing with services, and rapid rehousing. The housing move-in date is the date the client moved into a permanent housing unit. This may or may not be the same as the client's project start date and can be collected at entry, update, or exit. Now we'll review changes to services. Outreach contacts captured by outreach projects, PATH projects, and ESG-funded night-by-night shelters were previously collected based on the location of contact, such as a place not meant for human habitation or a service setting. With the 2017 data standards, contact will be reported based on whether or not the client was staying on the streets, an emergency shelter, or in a safe haven. If the worker is not able to determine whether a client is staying in any of these locations, it will be possible to note that as well. With the 2017 data standards, some pick list options have been reworded or removed. Let's take a few minutes to review these changes. The response options to the gender field have been reworded. The new pick list values will be trans female, MTF or male to female, trans male, FTM or female to male, and gender nonconforming, i.e. not exclusively male or female. Program entry date is now project start date. Program status date is now project status date. And program end date is now project end date. Response options to the destination field have also been changed. The former response, permanent housing for formerly homeless persons, such as COC project or HUD legacy programs or HOPO PH, has been reworded to permanent housing, other than RRH, for formerly homeless persons. In addition, rental by client, with RRH or equivalent subsidy, has been added as a response option. A few other response options have changed. For example, Social Security Disability Income, a response option to the Income and Sources fields, has been renamed Social Security Disability Insurance. The non-cash benefit options, Section 8, Public Housing or Rental Assistance, and Temporary Rental Assistance, have been removed. Next, we'll review changes to the standard enrollment screen for RHY-funded projects. Young persons' critical issues and family critical issues have essentially been combined to form one list, family critical issues, and the response options have been reduced to include unemployment, mental health issues, physical disability, alcohol or substance abuse, insufficient income to support youth, and incarcerated parent of youth. Response options for the referral source field have been streamlined and decreased to reduce data collection burden. Response options now include self-referral, individual, parent, guardian, relative, friend, foster parent, other individual, outreach project, temporary shelter, residential project, hotline, child welfare, /CPS, juvenile justice, law enforcement, /police, mental hospital, school, or other organization. Changes to the commercial sexual exploitation /sex trafficking field are relatively minor. The name of the field has been updated, and the data collection point has been changed from project start to project exit. The same is true for the field labor exploitation /trafficking. That is, the name has been updated, and the collection point has been changed from project start to project exit. There have been some significant changes to RHY services and referrals. We'll talk about those now. Formerly named Services Provided RHY, RHY Service Connections has been updated to include a reduced list of services. Service connections that have been removed include basic support services, counseling/therapy, dental care, parenting education for parent of youth, psychological or psychiatric care, recreational activities support group, preventative overnight interim, respite, preventative formal placement in a setting outside of PCP, preventative entry into BCP after preventative services, street outreach, health and hygiene products distributed, street outreach, food and drink items, and street outreach, services information /brochures. In addition to the reduced list of service connections, some response options to the RHY service connections field have been renamed. These include postnatal care for mother, substance abuse treatment, and substance abuse education /prevention services. There are also four new response options: home-based services, postnatal newborn care, wellness exams and immunizations, STD testing, and street-based services. The data element referral provided RHY has been retired. Next, we'll take a look at changes to the RHY standard exit screen. Clients are previously asked follow-up questions based on voluntary or involuntary completion status. With the 2017 data standards, voluntary status follow-up questions have been removed. Additionally, the Family Unification Achieved field has been removed. A few fields that were previously collected only at project start are now also collected at project exit. These fields are last grade completed, school status, and employment status. Fields that were previously collected at project start and now will be collected at project exit are commercial sexual exploitation /sex trafficking and labor exploitation /trafficking. New to the RHY standard exit screen are counseling fields. Briefly, these fields provide information about whether a client received counseling, and if so, the type and number of sessions received. The total number of sessions planned and whether a plan is in place to start or continue counseling is also collected. Also new to the RHY standard exit screen are safe and appropriate exit fields. These fields provide information about the safety of the client's exit destination, along with whether the client has various positive connections, such as an adult, peer, or community connections, outside of the project. Another element new to the RHY standard exit screen is Aftercare Plan. This field looks at whether aftercare was provided to the client, and if so, the primary way in which the aftercare was provided. This data element can be edited up to 180 days after the client's exit from the project. Now that we've covered the RHY changes, let's review the SSVF and VASH standard enrollment screen changes. The VAMC station number field was previously a text field in which the user would manually type in the VAMC station number. With the 2017 data standards, VAMC station number has been changed to a pick list field. Existing IPTECS values will be mapped to the new PIDList values. The use of Other Crisis Services section of the standard enrollment screen has been removed. Previously only required for PATH projects, connection with SOAR will now be required for SSVF projects. This data element will be collected at entry, annual slash status update, and at exit. New to HUD-VASH projects is the HUD-VASH voucher tracking element. As the name suggests, the purpose of this element is to collect information about the status of a VASH voucher. Response options for this particular field include referral package forwarded to PHA, voucher denied by PHA, voucher issued by PHA, voucher revoked or expired, voucher in use, veteran moved into housing, voucher was ported locally, voucher was administratively absorbed by a new PHA, voucher was converted to a housing choice voucher, veteran exited, voucher was returned, veteran exited, family maintained the voucher, veteran exited prior to receiving a voucher, and other. Finally, let's take a look at changes to the VASH standard exit screen. Users will now be required to collect HUD-VASH exit information on the exit screen. The field Case Management Exit Reason contains the following response options: accomplished goals and or obtained services and no longer needs case management, transfer to another HUD-VASH program site, found slash chose other housing, did not comply with HUD-VASH case management, eviction and or other housing related issues, unhappy with HUD-VASH housing, no longer financially eligible for HUD-VASH voucher, no longer interested in participating in this program, veteran cannot be located, veteran too ill to participate at this time, veteran is incarcerated, veteran is deceased, and other. All of the updates referenced throughout this video go into effect on October 1st, 2017. If you have any questions about the data standards after viewing this video, you may wish to review the 2017 Data Standards Dictionary. The dictionary can be found at www.hudexchange.info/resources/documents/hmis-data-dictionary.pdf. You may also direct any questions to the Nevada support team. In Southern Nevada, call 702-614-6690, extension 2. In Northern and Rural Nevada, call 775-562-4644, extension 2. You may also email the Nevada support team at nevada@bitfocus.com.